As of April 1st, 1993, there were 1,367 Navy photographers serving in 39 photo labs ashore and 53 labs at sea. These photographers provide the Navy with a broad range of photographic services. And, as naval photographers have done for over 70 years, they document Navy men and women at work, the mission of the Navy, and events taking place in the world around them. Recognizing the camera as a valuable tool in peace as well as war, and as an unmatched reporter of today's action for tomorrow's history, the Navy has invested time and money training the men and women behind the Navy cameras. All of this training, since 1951, has taken place at Building 1500, the Naval Schools of Photography, on the Naval Air Station in Pensacola, Florida. The Navy's association with photography began in the early 1900s. The photographic community back then was designed to meet the Navy's need for photographers who could cover aerial photo work. This consisted of mapping, photographing ships, buildings, gunnery practices, as well as intelligence and reconnaissance photography. Aerial photography was quickly becoming a Navy specialty at the end of World War II.
I must have been asked at least 1,000 times, what is the mission of naval photography? And I always tell them, reconnaissance / intelligence, because that's the reason we were created in the first place. In the meantime, we do a myriad of other things, but our basic mission is reconnaissance / intelligence.
In spite of post-war cutbacks, Navy photographers continue to document the events taking place around them. Two big events they photographed in 1946 were the atomic test conducted on Bikini Atoll in the Pacific and the start of Rear Admiral Byrd's expedition to the Antarctic.
Quackenbush went through the Naval School of Photography in 1934. I was his instructor down there. He used to give me a lot of credit. We went to Bikini to photograph the atomic bomb in 1946. Quackenbush was a senior photo officer in charge. He was directly under James Forrestal, at that time was Secretary of the Navy. I was in charge of all the aerial remote control photography for that operation. And during my school, there's a lot of important people that contributed a lot to photography. Now, Admiral Byrd was a great guy, and as you all know, is a great discoverer of the North and South Pole and photographed all over the ice down there. And they wanted some of our photographers to go, and one of my classmates was Joe Pelter. Joe Pelter was a seaman in the class, and later on he was promoted up to first class when Admiral Byrd requested that he go with him down to the South Pole. Well, Joe went down there and apparently did an outstanding job because he had that good old Naval School of Photography background, so he did a good job.
Photographer's mate Joseph Pelter received the Distinguished Flying Cross for his services as official photographer during his Antarctic expedition. Pelter was the first enlisted man ever in the Navy to win such an award. As photography's role in naval aviation grew, it was believed that a permanent school should be established. In June 1947, the old Army BOQ was renumbered Building 1500, and plans were immediately begun to convert the structure into the new home of naval photographic training. Over the years, the training of photo mates has changed from primarily aerial picture taking to a vast array of photographic capabilities. The first course photographers receive is the basic A school class. This course provides beginning photographers with in-depth classroom instruction on photographic equipment and material. Once a working knowledge of photography is instilled in the classroom, students test their comprehension through the utilization of hands-on training. This exposure to darkroom laboratory procedures provides the apprentice photographer with the necessary education needed to become proficient in photographic techniques. The photo school also offers advanced photography courses.
We have aerial film processing machines. It's still a high priority in the fleet. And it takes a special 8-week course to learn how to take one of these EH-38 machines, we call them, and they are aerial film processors, down to bare nuts and bolts and put it back together again. And then there's the camera repair.
The camera repairman course teaches the advanced student a broad range of repair techniques, including the operation, planned maintenance, and restoration of complex photographic equipment. The rebuilding of photographic gear by naval personnel enables the Navy to keep essential equipment online and ready to perform required assignments without having to return gear back to the manufacturer.
We also teach video cameraman jobs here, and that's a big part of our training.
The video production specialist course provides an expansive education in the area of video craftsmanship. Students are also exposed to all aspects of movie making, as well as a concentrated section dedicated to television studio production. The Naval School of Photography provides specific technical knowledge and practical experience to students that enable graduates to provide full photographic support to the Navy. On October 1, 1992, the school was consolidated with the other armed forces. The legendary Naval Schools of Photography was replaced with Defense Photography School. The new school will be the central training institution for all branches of the service.
I think it's pretty good move. One of the problems that we had in Desert Storm was the fact that we couldn't communicate with each other, that being all the other services. Everybody had a different way of doing business. All the language was different. Finally, all of us are going to get together, teach the same type of theory, the same type of practical application, and when it comes time for us to work out in the field together, we'll be able to do that a little bit more effectively.
The changeover to the Department of Defense ends an era of training photographers who have considered Building 1500 the home of naval photography. But no matter how the school changes, students have been and will always be associated with a school that provides camaraderie, education, and excellence.
Being an old Navy dedicated photographer, naturally my life and my heart and soul is wrapped around Navy photography. And so I am such a loyal Navy photographer. When I heard the fact that the Defense Department was going to take over naval photography and consolidate it up in Fort Meade or some other place in the Army, naturally that broke my heart. But I have to be realistic about it. I want photography to keep on making the progress, because if we have a war, I must state that the photography provides at least 80% of our intelligence on the enemy. And we must continue in photography what is supported by the Defense Department or by the continuing on as the Navy. And I'll just say, God bless you all, the Navy School of Photography and all the people connected with it, and because you're still part of my gang.
What is a Navy photographer? The ultimate profession.
I think that chief photographer's mates, or photographer's mates in general, are probably more closely knit than any rating that I ran into in the Navy. You've got to be sharper to get into naval photography, and therefore there is a more camaraderie, more closeness, more togetherness. The people that you knew there, I still remember the names and the faces of people that I knew in A school, and that was almost 35 years ago. I'll always have a place in my heart.